Students, now we are handling the topic straight lines in the bridge course. Junior JEE or track 24 and for MCET allies, track 24 bridge course. Bridge course is going up. 3 days we have discussed about the topic straight lines. First we have learned about slope, and depends upon the slope we have learned the equations of straight lines in the separate forms, in various forms, that equation of straight line passing through the origin and slope form, slope intercept form, and 2 points form, and equation of straight line in intercept form, like that we have learned. Today we can discuss, depends upon the straight line concept, how to solve the straight lines. I think you have learned two methods in 10th class. Until 10th class you have learnt two methods to solve the given lines or given to algebraic equations. Let us start here. Solutions of two equations. Solutions of two equations. That is, example. Let us write here the line 3x plus 2y equal to 5 and 2x minus 3y equal to minus 1. Let us, two equations are given here. How to solve the equations? I think you have learned about solving of two equations in two methods. From 8th class only have learnt this question. Depends upon this one you can write 2y is equal to 5 minus 3x. This is a model. And y is equal to 5 minus 3x by 2. This value, instead of y, you can substitute that value in 2. So instead of y, you substitute the value in second equation. It becomes 2x is equal to, let it be third equation. It becomes 2x minus 3 into 5 minus 3x by 2 is equal to minus 1. Now we can write by taking LCM, 4x minus 3 5s of 15 minus of minus plus minus whole by 2 is equal to minus 1. Here we can write 4x plus 9x becomes 13x minus 15 is equal to minus 2. So 13x is equal to 15, taken that side, 15 minus 2 becomes 13. So x is equal to 1. Whenever x is equal to 1 we got, you can substitute the value in 1. So you can get the value as 5 minus 3 into 1 by 2. So 5 minus 3 into 1 by 2, you can write this one as 2 by 2. Therefore, x is equal to 1 and y is equal to 1. I think you have learnt this one in 8th class standard. Now what I am doing, solution of two lines. Maybe in 8th class they will not say that these are lines, simply these are called as linear equations in two variables. These are called as linear equations. Linear equations in two variables. In 9th class also you faced such problems. Now here I want to discuss with you that The line is of the form ax plus by plus c equal to 0 or ax plus by minus c equal to 0, you know, constant. This is L1 equal to 0 and this is L2 equal to 0. If the lines are intersect, wherever the intersecting point is there, the point is called as point of intersection. Here, x is equal to 1 and y is equal to 1 means the point of intersection. The point of intersection is x is equal to 1 and y is equal to 1. This is 8th class method. Let us know about the how many methods are there to solve the equations. Next, one method we have learnt, that is called as converting two variables into a single variable. 2x plus 3y, otherwise 3x plus 2y equal to 5 and 2x minus 3y equal to minus 1 he given. We have converted the variable y in terms of x and we have substituted the value in second equation and we got the same answer, that is in terms of only x. Whenever we got in terms of x, later we have substituted the x value in first equation or second equation, anything, you can get the same answer. Then that is called as single variable method. Now we can discuss in another way also. So this is the line. About line, I want to discuss with you some matter. This is the line x by a plus y by b is equal to 1. X by a plus y by b is equal to 1 is called as equation of line. Equation of line in intercept form. Equation of line in intercept form. So here you can take LCM. Bx plus ay by ab is equal to 1. That implies bx plus ay is equal to ab. You can write here bx plus ay minus ab equal to 0. Bx plus ay minus ab equal to 0. This one you can understand that this ab is a constant. This ab is a constant. So equation of line, equation of line is called as here. Equation of line, that is in general form. Equation of line in general form, that is. Equation of line in general form is, let this is, b is constant, of course you can write a. And ax plus this is by plus c equal to 0. Equation of line in general form you can understand as like this. Ax plus by plus c equal to 0 or lx plus my plus n is equal to 0. Sir, why do you say this one now? You can get a doubt. Until 8th class and 9th class, this is notated as simply equation in linear equation in two variables. What is the linear equation? Linear means 1. Whatever the power x or power y is 1, it is called as linear. If the power x is 2, it is called as second degree equation or quadratic equation. If a power of x or y is 3, it is called as a cubic equation. If power of x and y is 4, it is called as fourth order equation. If power is n, it is called as nth order equation. If x and y are two variables are there, then it is called as linear equation in two variables. If simply 3x plus 5 is equal to 9, it is called as linear equation in one variable. Otherwise, if this is 5y plus 3 is equal to 5, it is called as also equation of line in one variable. Otherwise, it is called as simply linear equation in one variable. Now, this is linear equation two variables. That linear equation two variables, now I am going to discuss with you about an equation of line. That general equation of line is here ax plus by plus c equal to 0 or lx plus my plus n is equal to 0 model. Any equation can be identified as the equation of a straight line in general form. Hereafter, you should not forget the term that if any equation given in the form of ax plus by plus c equal to 0 or lx plus my plus n equal to 0 is called as equation of straight line in general form. form. Now, for this equation, I am comparing with the slope, students. Put here a, a comma 0. Put here b, 0 comma b. On that day, I think 2 days back, I said slope is equal to formula here, b minus 0 by 0 minus a. So it is minus b by a. Minus b by a is slope here. So what is happening here? The slope here. The slope is, students, we use the formula y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1 concept. Here, minus b by a. So slope you can write. Slope is equal to minus coefficient. Minus coefficient of x by coefficient of y. Minus coefficient of x by coefficient of y. That is equal to minus b by a. Now, depends upon this one. Depends upon this one. So, what is the slope of ax plus by plus c equal to 0? Now, let us going to discuss about slope of line ax plus by equal to 0, that is equal to minus coefficient of x by coefficient of y, that is equal to minus a by b. Next, slope of line lx plus my plus n is equal to 0 is minus coefficient of x by coefficient of y, minus l by m. This slope now, can you say here slope? Slope is equal to minus coefficient of x by coefficient of y. Here you can say slope is equal to minus 2 by minus 3. It becomes 2 by 3. So here the two lines are perpendicular. I said in previous class I said that if M1, M2, M1 is equal to M2, the lines are said to be parallel. If M1 into M2, if M1 into M2 is equal to minus 1, here minus 3 by 2 into 2 by 3, what will happen? 2, 2 get cancelled, 3, 3 get cancelled, is minus 1. Therefore, lines are perpendicular. Lines are perpendicular lines. For the perpendicular lines, here the point of intersection forms, we should calculate the point of intersection of two lines. So, now I want to discuss with you the concept from 8th class and 9th class, linear equations in two variables to the straight line. Just, I said the brief discussion regarding straight lines. Now, what is happening? The two lines are perpendicular lines. Whenever perpendicular lines are, there are any intersecting lines, there will be a point of intersection. There should be a point of intersection if the lines are intersecting lines. We should calculate the point of intersection now. Okay, let us discuss point of intersection in another method. I think you know about the point of intersection method also. Here 3x is there, 2y is there, here 2x is there, 3y is there. Let us write like this. 3 into 1. 3 2s are 6. So 2 into 1 unit. 1, if I put round means it is equation. This is 2 means with the number. Here 3 into 2 you can write. So multiply with like this. 6x, 2 3s are 6x plus 2 2s are 4y. 6x plus 4y is equal to 10. For full equation, you should multiply with the number 2. For full equation, you should multiply with the number 3. 6x minus 9y is equal to minus 3. Now, subtract. It becomes, it is minus, it is plus, it is plus. 6x, 6x get cancelled. 13y is equal to 13. Therefore, y is equal to 13 by 13. It becomes 1. Therefore, y is equal to 1. Now, substitute in any way. I mean in any equation, sub in 1, you can get here 3x plus 2 into 1 is equal to 5. Now 3x plus 2 is equal to 5. 3x is equal to 5 minus 2. 3x is equal to 5 minus 2. 3x is equal to 3. 3x equal to 3, that is therefore x is equal to 1. Now here I am writing point of intersection. Point of intersection of lines is equal to 1 comma 1 is the correct answer. Now I want to discuss with you another method. Total 4 methods are there, students. First one, 8th class method, taking y, a single variable, and substituting in x in any other equation, getting the only one variable method. Next, second one, by multiplying with the numbers. Third one, matrix method is there. I think you did not learn matrices in 8th class, 9th class or 10th class. So I will discuss in matrices chapter, that is 1A topic. Now I am in 1B geometry topic. Let us finish some days this one. Later I will discuss that one. Now we can discuss about another method that is very important and very useful method in first entire geometry. Hereafter you should learn and you should remember the method. This is easy method. At a time you will be getting the answer. Third method I am writing, which is intermediate method. Third method. Solve it. 3x plus 2y. This 5 taken this side. Minus 5 equal to 0, comma 2x minus 3y. That minus 1 taken this side, it becomes plus 1 equal to 0. We can write here, the method is that, first of all, you should write the coefficient of y. Method I am writing, solving method. So what is solving method in intermediate? Whatever the y coefficient is there, you should write here y coefficient. So put here 2. Later, you should put constant minus 5. Later, you should write constant x coefficient. And again, whatever the y coefficient you had written, simply you should write here. First y coefficient, it is rule. First y coefficient, next constant, next x coefficient, again next y coefficient. In the similar way, here also, you should write first y coefficient, minus 3, next constant 1. Next x coefficient 2 and next minus 3. This is for x. We should calculate determinant process. This is for y and this is for 1. So what is this means here? Try to understand like this. X by, you should multiply like this. This is rule, student. Rule is called as matrices rule, AD minus BC. This 2 should multiply with 1. 2 into 1. Put minus symbol, it is a rule. Minus into whatever the numbers are there, here you should write. Minus 3 into minus 5. That is equal to y here by like this. Put minus 5. Minus 5 into 2. Into means put bracket, don't get confused. Minus 1 into this number. Middle minus is the rule, students. 1 by, you should write. Again, in this way, you should write 3 into minus 3, minus 2 into 2. 3 into minus 3, minus 2, this is, minus 2 into 2. That implies, next step, x by 2, 1s are 2. Here minus into minus into minus becomes minus, minus 15 is equal to y by, here minus 10 minus 3, it is equal to 1 by minus 9 minus 4. That implies, here I am writing, that implies x by 2 minus 15 becomes minus 13, y by minus 10 minus 3 becomes minus 13. 1 by minus 9 minus 4 becomes minus 13. In next step you should write x by minus 13 equal to this one should be equal to this one one time. 1 by minus 13 comma y by minus 13 equal to 1 by minus 13. So x is equal to, you can write here, minus 13 by minus 13. And y is equal to minus 13 by minus 13. Therefore, x is equal to 1 comma y equal to 1. Therefore, if the lines, whether it is perpendicular or intersecting anyone, doesn't matter, student. This is the point of intersection 1 comma 1. So, 1 comma 1 is the point of intersection of two lines. Point of intersection equal to 1 comma 1. By observing this one, you may get that, sir, this is a lengthy model, sir, whatever the sums in previous method we have, already we have learned, it is easy method, sir, like that the student feel, student used to feel like that, I know. But see, without writing direct steps, I had written here every step neatly and in clear manner. But you should acclimatize, you have to habituate to do this method, because this is most important, this is most necessary method. Plenty of sums you will be facing hereafter regarding this model. Now, theory depends upon this one. I will say theory and I will give some homework. Solving the point of intersection. Solving two lines, you can write. To get the point of intersection. Solving two straight lines. Solving two straight lines. Which are in the form of, solving two straight lines which are in the form of L1, you put L1 equal to A1x plus B1y plus C1 equal to 0 comma L2 is equal to A2x plus B2y plus C2 equal to 0. There is no property whether the lines are perpendicular or not. Of course, if the lines are parallel, there will be no point of intersection. So, whatever the cases arises, the point of, to get the point of intersection, perpendicular concept to simply intersecting concept and parallel concept to, if the lines are collinear concept, I will discuss later. Now, let us calculate this one, L1 equal to 0, and this one, L2 is equal to 0. Okay, if the two straight lines L1 equal to 0 and L2 is equal to 0 are the intersecting lines, then how to solve the lines? Simply, theory I am saying now, solving. Solving L1 comma L2. First of all, we should write the coefficient of y. Now, you can put here B1 for first one or second one. For first one, you write coefficient of y. It is B1. Next, you should put C1. Next, you should write coefficient of x. It is rho. Next, you should write the coefficient of y once again. Once again, in the similar way, for a second line, you should put B2 coefficient of y and a constant and the coefficient of x and the coefficient. This is the process. This is for x, this is for pi, this is for 1. Now, you can write x by, according to this theory, you can write b1 c2, b1 c2 minus b2 c1, and y by, this is small way we can write, y by, this is the theory, c1 a2. C1A2 minus C2A1 is equal to 1 by, you can write like this, A1B2. A1B2 minus A2B1, that implies. You can write here, x by B1C2 minus B2C1 is equal to 1 by A1B2, 1 by A1B2 minus A2B1, comma, y by, you can write here, C1A2 minus C2E1 is equal to 1 by A1B2 minus A2B1. Therefore, point of intersection P is equal to, this is the point of intersection P, is equal to x comma y. You can get the answer as this one taking this side and this one taking this side. You can write here B1C2 minus B2C1. B1C2 minus B2C1 by A1B2 minus A2B1, comma C1A2. C1A2 minus C2A1 by A1B2 minus A2B1. This is A1B2. Some students used to remember that the equation of, if two equations of straight lines are there, the point of intersection of the two lines, they used to remember as B1, as the formula B1C2 minus B2C1 by A1B2 minus C2B1, comma C1A2 minus C2B1 by A1B2 minus C2B1. Once again, you can remember also B1C2 minus B2C1 by A1B2 minus C2B1, comma C1A2 minus C2B1 by, sorry, C1A2 minus C2A1, sorry, B1C2 minus B2C1 by A1B2 minus C2B1, comma C1A2 minus C2A1 by A1B2 minus C2B1. A1B2 minus C2B1 is common for both. For numerator, first one B1C2 minus B2C1. And for numerator, second C1A2 minus C2A1. So, you can understand that for first one, for first A letter, A1B2 minus C2B1 common. For first one, A should not be A, next letter B. Whenever B1, just two letters only, B and C we are having. B1C2 minus B2C1. And letter C1, cyclic order like that. B next letter C, C next A, C1A2 minus C2A1, that's all. You can remember. Using this formula, let us do a sum. Using this formula, let us do a sum. Solve. 8x plus 3y equal to 22, and 4x minus 5y equal to 12. Simply I given the value, students. This is 1, this is 2. So you can write here given lines 8x plus 3y minus 22 equal to 0. Here you can write, because this is of the form within brackets I am writing, a1x plus b1y plus c1 equal to 0. So a1 is equal to, you can write 8, the coefficient, b1 equal to 3, c1 equal to minus 22. Next you write 4x minus 5y minus 12 equal to 0. This is of the form a2x plus b2y plus c2 equal to 0. Now you can understand this one as a2 equal to 4 and b2 equal to minus 5, comma b2 equal to minus 5, comma c2 is equal to minus 12. Therefore, now we should calculate point of intersection. Point of intersection, let us write the formula b1 c2 minus b2 c1 by a1 b2 minus a2 b1, comma c1 a2 minus c2 a1 by a1 b2 minus a2 b1. This is a2. a1 b2 minus a2 b1. Whatever the values a1 b1 c1 are there, I had written each and every value. So depends upon this formula, I am substituting the value and getting the result. Point of intersection P we can put. What is B1 here? 3. What is C2 here? Minus 12. 3 into minus 12. Minus B2 C1. Minus of minus 5 here. C1, what is C1 here? Minus 22. By A1 B2. A1 means 8. Into B2 means minus 5. 8 into minus a1 b2 minus a2 b1. So 4 into b1 is 3, comma c1 a2. So c1 means minus 22. Minus 22 into a2 means 4. Minus c2 a1. C2 means here minus half. Minus 12 into a1 meaning here 8. By same, this answer will be repeated because the formula in denominator is same. A1 B2 minus A2 B1. 8 into minus 5 minus A2 means 4 into B1 means 3. That's all. Now you can calculate this one as 3 into minus 12. 3 into minus 12 is minus 36. This is minus half, minus half, minus 5 into 22 equal to 110 by this is minus 40 minus 12, comma this is minus 88 plus 96, 12 8s are minus of minus becomes plus. This is minus 40 minus 12, 36 and 110 you can add, both are minus, you can add and write the symbol minus. Minus 146 by 52, comma this is 8 by minus 52. 8 by minus 52. Both minus will be getting cancelled. If you get cancelled this one with the 2 table, 73 by 26 the answer. If you get cancelled with the 4th table, minus 2 by 13, otherwise 4 by 26 we can. This is the point of intersection. So I said here, now 4 methods. First one, taking y and substituting into x variable. And next one, x and y simply multiplying with 2 number or 3 number. And next one, solving Weissach's method. Of course, using the theory solving Weissach's method, this one. Whatever easy you can follow, but you should habituated, you should become habituated to solve this method. So better to follow this method onwards. Now I will give 2 sums homework. You try yourself in this method or Weissach's method, anything. You should get the, if you are having any doubt, solve in any method and you should get the same answer for all methods. Second sum, 3x minus 33y equal to 12 and x plus 6 7y is equal to 8. Students, use your own brain and solve these two sums and put the answer in WhatsApp group. Okay, students, we can discuss next concept in next class.